The roof is one of the most important components of any building, and that's why there's some hesitancy to installing solar on roofs. But with the right equipment and installation methods, solar can be installed on any shingle roof to prevent future leaks. So Larry, talk to us a little bit about what are the components used to install solar on a shingle roof.
So there's three main components. We have the flashing itself.
Yeah.
We have the L-foot, and then we have the lag bolt.
Okay.
So the flashing goes up under the layer of shingles. The shingles come down to about right here. We put a bead of sealant in the back just as an extra layer of protection so that water can run down over there. You see there's a little lip right there.
Right.
So that keeps water flowing down and not in through the hole. And then next we have the L-foot, which goes on top and lands right in there.
Right.
And then on the L-foot, we can put our rail and put our solar module on top of that. And then through the hole in the L-foot, we put down our lag bolt, and that goes right down into the rafter to secure it in place.
How do we keep this from leaking?
So the best thing that I can say is it just needs to be installed according to the manufacturer's specs. So these are made to keep from leaking. I already mentioned the bead of sealant on the back,
yep,
which is on the bottom side. That's an extra layer of protection. There's a washer, a rubber washer right there, so that goes on top. Then there's a washer on top of the lag bolt. And those are all, in my opinion, extra protections just to make sure that over a long period of time, there's no leaks.
And what about, should people be concerned about the warranty to their roof?
So that is definitely something to consider. Now, there's a couple of things that we do. First of all, we use components like this that are already approved by the main manufacturers of shingles in the U.S.
Yeah.
And then also, if you have a new roof, we'll reach out to your roofer. We'll have a conversation with them just to make sure that we're not doing anything that they don't approve of so that they can keep their warranty on the roof.
Great. And then what are some things to think about if somebody already has solar on their roof and they're thinking about either now replacing their roof or they have a roof and they want to do repairs to a certain area of their roof?
So that's something that I really encourage customers to keep in mind ahead of time.
Yeah.
So if your roof is 10 years old, just get it replaced ahead of time. If you have any issues on the roof, get it replaced before you go solar, because we can come back later and take panels off, put them back on again, but that's pretty expensive to do that at a later time.
Sure. And what if you're building, say, a new house or a new building for your business? What are some of the things you should be mindful of when going solar or putting attachments onto a shingle roof?
So it's always ideal to collaborate with the builder.
Yep. You know,
we can collaborate. We can talk about conduit runs. We can talk about how they set up the electric service so it's easier to interconnect. As far as the roof, there are some roof attachments that a shingle roof installer can put right on the shingles as they're installing them.
Okay.
And then their warranty and their work, it's all intact at that point.
And then when it comes to shingle roofs, what type of shingle roofs can we attach to? Have we attached to? Have we had experience with?
So this is for an asphalt shingle roof.
Right.
And that's 99.9% of what we do. We have installed on cedar shake. That can work. It's going to be a bigger flashing that's a little bit more expensive, and it's going to be additional labor, so there's some additional costs there. There's also metal shingles. There's slate roofs. That just requires working with a roofing company that actually has done that work, has actually installed that roofing material, working with them to help us with the attachments. We've not done anything like that. We'd be willing to do that, but obviously that's a significant additional cost. And then if you're out in the West Coast, there's the ceramic roof tiles, which are pretty common in Southern California.
Sure.
A lot of solar panels installed on roofs with ceramic roof tiles can be done. Again, that's more expensive. Not something that we've done here on the East Coast, but certainly can be done.
Great. If you enjoyed this video, leave a comment in the comment section below. Even if you didn't enjoy it, leave a comment, but make sure to let us know why. Our YouTube channel is full of videos on solar, batteries, and more. Make sure you go to check them out.